Rich, come on, it's almost lunchtime and you've done absolutely nothing. It's time to do couch to cardio. Get up.
Yeah, you're right. It is time to do it. I need some motivational music. Alexa, play some motivational music. Alexa, are you joking?
How much do dead batteries cost? Nothing. They're free of charge.
Alexa, play some motivational music. Right, I can run this. Hi everyone, I'm Rich from Tiger Fitness. This is Katrina. She's going to be joining us for our cardio and core workout today. Now the timings for your cardio and core are simple. 60 seconds worth of cardio, straight into 45 seconds worth of core, and you get a 30 second rest between your exercises. Four sets for your cardio, four sets for your core, and we're going to go round for three whole rounds. Let's do this. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do this. Your first movement team is going to be running the sport. It's going to be very simple, just like this. When I give you the shout, and I shout left, it's left hand down to the floor. We come straight back up again. I shout right, right hand down to the floor. 60 seconds of that, then we're going to go 45 seconds into your sit-ups. Here comes the timer team. Make sure you've had a good warm-up. And let's do this. Right, on the spot then. Just jogging on the spot, we're gonna bring those arms in. If you haven't had a warm-up, you can use this first round as your warm-up, and then use rounds two and rounds three to really kick some ass. Left, down, good. Right, all right. Looking right in here as well. Left. Left. Chest is up high. Make sure we're engaged in that core. Right. The whole point of this workout, especially the start with, is just to get the heart rate going and get the blood going around the body. Right. Left. Left. 10 more seconds, then we're gonna go down to our sit-ups. Right, left, three, two, right. Take it down to the floor for your sit-ups. Straight down. In this position, fingers on the temples, up we come. Control the movement back down again. We're working. Big squeeze at the top. Pump that chest up. If you need to at home, you're more than welcome to tuck your toes underneath the sofa or something, or weight your feet. If you want the progression with this movement, as you come up, you can go into a rotation. So rotate round, bring the opposite knee to the opposite elbow, and spin it back down again. One more rep. Okay, that would come. So you've got 30 seconds recovery time here. Shake it out. So your next move we're gonna go into a squat. So it's just gonna be 30 seconds of squats here. After we hit the 30 second mark, we're gonna go down to pulses. So it's gonna be five pulses into a squat jump. We're gonna come back down again. Regressed version is to lose the jump and just come out of your pulse into a squat and come back down. Core movement and leg raises. So feet shoulder width apart. Down we go, and just come up and down with your squats to start with. Now, if you've had a full warm-up and you want to completely blast those legs, you can go straight into those pulses and straight into those squat jumps to start with if you'd like. 15 seconds, got to these. Make sure when we come up, we're tucking that pelvis in, pulling the chest through, engaging the core. Right, 3 seconds. Team, join me down here for your pulse. One, two, three, four, five. Add the jump. Two, three, four, five. Jump. Two, three, four, five. Jump. Good. Two, three, four, five. Jump. Keep it moving. We've got 10 seconds. Jump. Two, three, four, five. Jump. Two, three, four, 5, jump, team take it down to the ground, leg raises. Hands underneath the lower of the back, the top of the bum. Gonna raise the legs up, control the movement back down again. If you want the extra, as you raise up, you can pulse those heels up towards the ceiling. If you don't have any issues with your back, feel free to bring the arms out high, low, wherever you can, and just make it a bit harder for your core to work. Oh yeah. Nice control through the breathing. One more rep, team. Up. And bring it down. Your next movement are those high knee pulls. So I want those arms up, one of those heels back. We're in this position. Go imagine you've got someone's head in your hand that you don't like, and we're just gonna pull the head down towards the knee. 30 seconds on one side, 30 seconds on the opposite side. The core movement after that, we're going to your plank with your heel raises. So bring your arms up, heel back, and start drawing the knee in. Really pull it up. Remember, you don't like this person whose head you're kneeing off your knee. I'm pretty passive, obviously. There's no one I do not like at the moment. Okay, we've got 5 seconds left. 3, 2, 1, switch sides in. Team, if you want the extra when you do the movement, you can add the jump in. You get the power through the bottom leg as well. Boom, 15 seconds. Really reach up as high as you can. Kick that heel back as far as you can. Keep that pressure in the front leg. 5 seconds. Okay, team, down to the floor. Right, in that plank frame. We're gonna kick the heel up. When we're kicking the heels up, I'm gonna try and keep the leg as long as possible. We'll try and keep the hips down as low as possible. Regression for the move here is what Katrina's doing. It's just down to the toes and hold a normal plank, or down to the knees. As long as the tension remains there in that core, that's all we're really worried about. Kick it up. Keep it squeezing. Last one, team. Okay, up we come. Take a breath, take a breather. Okay, next one is the walkout push-ups with a lateral jump. So from this position, we're walking out into your push-up frame, coming up. When we come up, we're gonna be in our squat frame, we jump across, switch sides, all right? If you haven't got space to do that at home, don't worry about the lateral jump, just worry about the jump. Core movement of these sits. Okay, team, let's go. Walk it out, into that push-up, walk it all the way back up. As soon as you're there, jump it across. Here we go. Boom, there we go, that's it. Feel free, if you want it, when you jump, add the tuck in and take it down. Boom. Team just gone 30 seconds. See how many more we can get out here. Try and plan for about 4 more. Up. Oh yeah. We jump. 8 seconds to go. I remember we got 2 more. This being one of them. Jump across. Actually, take a straight back down. We're going to go these sits. Just going to get this mat out for Katrina. So we're on the floor, on our bums. Just going to raise those knees up, kick those heels out, keep the tension there in the core. Squeeze that tension in. If you want the extra, you can bring those arms up so they're parallel with the floor. 8, That's it, kick them nose out. Really tap the knees. Team, feel free to challenge yourselves. You should not be able to talk like me during this. If you can, you're not pushing yourselves hard enough. All right, 30 seconds rest. So now you know the whole format. We're gonna go back through, and do it three more times. How do you feel about that?
Great.
You know what? Right, 5 seconds. Take a breather. Ready for running?
Yeah.
Okay, go. So on the spot. Round two now. So we're encouraging those knees up a little bit higher. Lift. Down to the floor. Here we go. Control that core work. Right. 15 seconds gone. We're looking good. Feel free to keep that pace up as well. Lift. Lift. That's it. We want the pressure working through the legs. We want the pressure working through the back. Right. Yep. Right. 25 seconds to go. Remember, we've got sit-ups after this. Lift. Right. Final 10. Let's give a bit more of a boost. Lift. Come on. Ready for the setups, team? 3, 2, 1, take it down to the floor. Legs involved, fingers on the temples, up we come. Raising that chest up. Remember that progression, team, if you want it. Progression here, elbow to the opposite knee. As we rotate round. Regression, if we need it, is just your simple crunch. We come up as far as we can. And we bring it back down to the floor. If you need that regression, that's fine. Just make sure when you're up here, that core's working. 45 degree angle is what you're looking for. In with the rotational work. Last rep here. Boom. Good job. How are you feeling?
Good.
Good.
Done.
So we now know what's coming next, those squats. So you've got the option, if you want to go pulses for the full 60 seconds, be my guest, it's absolutely fine. Back slightly. If not, squats for 30, then add your pulses in. So feet shoulder width apart, and bring the bum down. Just into those squats, team. If you want the extra, just make sure that your heels are planted down. You don't want to go to pulses yet. You can go to them speed squats like this and you start pumping them up. So we're all gonna count. Yes. Keep moving, okay, 10 more seconds left. 3 to go. Right, pulses with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, jump. 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 Last little bit. Pulse it. Okay, let's bring it down. Leg raises to the floor. Legs out. Hands underneath the lower back. And we're up in the air. Controlling those legs down. All the way through. Trying to get those legs up high so the heels become in line with those hips. At the top. All the way, let's move. Little bit of struggle going on this room. Last few seconds. Last rep. And control it down. Woo! You good? Right, team. Next movement. are those knee pulls, the extended knee pulls. Starting off on this side, we're gonna get ready for it, okay? Really start smashing in. We're going down to the floor for the plank with the heel raise. 5 seconds. Okay, here we go. Pull. Now, so you'd be happy to know that we are halfway through this workout. We're now into the second half. The second half means we need to work out harder. Keep your heel back. 15 seconds gone. Really pulling that head. Make sure we're crunching that core in. Boom, boom. 5 seconds. All right, switch the sides. Here we go. And pump it. Good, big extension on that back leg as we land the foot. Really pulling the knee up and in. 15 seconds to go. Hey, come on. Last few seconds. Okay, down to the floor, into that plank frame as you raise those heels up. Alexa, play some workout music. Apparently she doesn't work with kids or technology. Okay, keep going. There we go. That's it, we're holding, we're strong. Keep working through. Last few seconds. Keep them kicking up. And take it down. Okay. Walk out push-ups to the squat jump to the side. Your heat up. Feels very hot here. Okay, chest up. Get ready to walk out. Right, I'll stand here. You know, slightly behind. Chest up, ready to. Here we go. All the way. Come out of frame. Good. Up. Here we go. Nice, ready? Here we go. Deep as we can. We work, yeah? Lateral. Good. Deep as we can with the chest, add the jump, and walk it back up. Give those hands. Boom. Step here. Come on, team, we've got 20 seconds left. There you go. Alright, get down. Teammate, this is the last one if you need to. Bring yourselves up. Get ready for your zip before your V-sit. Down we go. On the bum. Tuck the knees up. And kick those heels out. Make sure every movement's going. Now, if you feel like your quads have just been suffering because of walkout push-ups, and you need a second, alright, give yourself a sec. Check your legs out, you can have a little breather. As soon as you're ready though, straight back in, 100% effort. Tuck them up high, kick the heels out. Oh yeah. We work, last couple of seconds. Yes. Alright. I'll be calm. Set number 2 done. Last set. Get your drink if and when you need it. Right, we know what we're going to do to start with. And that's a running. Okay, get yourself ready. Set number 3. Oh, he runs. Here we go. On the spot. Starts when we need to go on. Left. Right, left, It's alright team, fatigue is real. Once you start getting fatigued, start losing your mind. Right. In all fairness to her, it is bloody hot in here. Left. Left. Get the knees going. Halfway through, right. Left. Right. Left. Good, that's it. Come on, keep that heart rate high. 20 seconds. Left. Straight back in again, knees up. Right. Yes, working with your team. 10 more seconds, left. To the end. 5 seconds, we're gonna go down. 2 sit-ups. 2, 1, down to the ground. One down. Here we go. Fingers on those temples. Go around. Add that rotational move. If you want it. Keep it as strong as that core. Remember, every movement, 100% of your effort. If it starts dwindling down, give yourself a couple of second rest. Take some breaths, get some air into the lungs, and come back stronger. We're almost there. We got it. One more rep. Whoop. Boom, good start, up we come. Woo. Right, squats next. You enjoyed this last one, didn't you? Team, if your legs are starting to hurt, don't join in with the pulses until 45 seconds in. I'll give you a countdown for that, so it's fine. If you want to do more, start with your pulses or start 15 seconds in. Feet shoulder width apart, bum down. Here we go. Just easy for the squats to start with. Dropping that bum down. In line with the knee line or below that knee line. On a good range of motion, more of the legs have got to work. Yes. Keep the front of that core engaged. 10 more seconds here. Solid in those heels. Right, get ready for your pulses. One more. Okay, join us down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Team, if you want to join in now, you absolutely can do. And jump. 2, 3, 4, 5. Last few seconds. 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Up we come. Down to the ground, leg raises. We've got this, we're almost there. In position, hands in position, up we come, the legs. We control the movement back down again. Controlling that breathing, controlling the movements with the legs. Try not to do this. It's not really gonna do you any good. You need to be slow. You need to be controlled. You need that time under tension for your core to kick in and work. If leg raises are too much for you, have a slight bend in the knees and just rock the legs back. Or you can go singles. We're just here, we raise up. Okay, 2 more rounds to go. We got this. We got it. Okay, take that breather in. Right. Even with a knee kick to start with. Taking that breath in. Find your stance. Find the direction you're gonna start with. Get ready for it. And start pulling the hands down to meet the knee. Pull, 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 pull. Seconds. Keep the intensity high. We work and work and work. Ready to switch sides and switch. Here we go. Yep, 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 yep. Big 30 seconds on each side. kicking the leg out as far as we can. Big extension to your legs. And high. 15 seconds to go. Come on, Katrina. Bring them knees up. 5 seconds, get ready to go down for your plank. Okay. Bring it down. We're in position for the plank. And let's move. Heel up as high as you can. Keeping those legs engaged and as straight as possible. Should feel the core working right around the front. Should feel it lengthening. Should feel it stretching. We're powering up. Try and keep those hips down low. In line. Squeeze the glutes in. One more. One more to go. One more. Walk out push-ups with your lateral squat jump. We'll finish off with the big sits. Ready for this?
Yeah.
All ready. All ready. Right, deep breath in. Ready for a little stomp. Okay, let's take it down, walk it out. Down for the push-up, all the way up. Ready for the squat jump. Here we go. Yes. Down nice and deep. Ready. Good. Do it. Good job. Stand it. And jump it. Yes. Keep the workout going. Do watch those wrists when you're walking out. Try not to go too fast. You start to lose grip strength, wrist strength, and you injure yourself. You'll be out for longer than what you need to. Yes, up we go, and jump. Remember, if you want that progression team, when you jump in, and you're not restricted to space, you can add that top jump in. Last movement here. Take it as strong as we can. Bring yourselves up, then take it down to the ground. A few V-sits. Last set. Bum down. Kick the knees up. Control the breathing. Control the movement. Really try and keep those heels off the ground. You're going to encourage that core to keep the tension and ultimately for it to work harder. Run it. Come on. Good. So you keep those shoulders up. Put your hands to the ground. There you go. Now tuck the knees in. There we go. You got it. One more. All right. That's us done 3 rounds. What are you thinking, buddy?
Tired.
Woo! Well, guys, there you have it. Your cardio endurance and core strength class for you to follow along at home using the space that you've got, whether it be a little dining room area like this or out in the garden. Make sure you're warming up fully before you do it, or use the first round as you warm up. And when you finish, you have a good stretch down for 3 to 5 minutes. If you like the video, guys, just give us a thumbs up. If you want to see more content, then do subscribe. See you soon. 2, 1.
Okay.